بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. طبعا نحن نبارك الجميع لنجاح المؤتمر والثامن والثلاثون صاحب قيادة الأستاذ الدكتور هاني حافظ والدكتور عمرو حسين والدكتور أيمن الرفاعي، نجاح مستمر ونتمنى نجاح لجمعيتنا إن شاء الله باستمرار. My talk today about kidney diseases and pregnancy. It's challenging but possible. My agenda included renal diseases and pregnancy. How about UTI, AKI, CKD, GN, chronic dialysis, and renal transplant patient? How about relationship between pregnancy and kidney disease? Effect of pregnancy on kidney disease, worsening proteinuria, loss of kidney function, hypertension, and preeclampsia. How about the effect of kidney disease on pregnancy, mediated to infertility, preterm delivery, intrauterine growth retardation, decreased fetal survival, and preeclampsia. How about UTI? 1 to 2% of pregnancy has UTI associated with intrauterine death, premature labor, hypertension and anemia, significant bacteria, cystitis and pyelonephritis. How about pyelonephritis? 70% have asymptomatic bacteria, mostly in second trimester, symptom pain, fever, dysuria, complication and endotoxic shock, DIC and acute renal failure. Treatment hydration, IV antibiotic for 24 hours to 48, then it changes to oral for at least 10 to 14 days. Cystitis symptoms, urgency, frequency, and dysuria. No systemic signs. Culture may be negative. Recurrence 17%, usually does not progress to pyelonephritis. Asymptomatic bacteria 2 to 7% of pregnancy. No pyelonephritis, 30% progress to pyelonephritis. Increase the risk of premature labor and low birth weight. Treatment by cephalosporin 3 to 7 days. High recurrence rate, 35%. Safety of antibiotic during pregnancy. Category A, drugs taken by large number of pregnant women without proven harm, like amoxicillin, ampicillin, cephalosporin, nitrofurantoin, and penicillin. Category B, 1, drugs taken by limited number of pregnant women within harm and animal data safe, cefotaxim, bibracillin, clavulonic acid. But category B2 and B3, C and D, all are contraindicated during pregnancy, like vancomycin, cefofloxacin, sulfa, tetracycline, gentamicin. How about AKI in pregnancy? Pregnancy-related AKI in young women worldwide is an important cause of maternal and fetal morbidity and mortality. Rates of acute kidney injury in pregnancy are generally declining worldwide, but remain a significant public health concern in developing countries. Causes of AKI for developing countries: severe sepsis from septic abortion, hypertensive disorders, hemorrhage. In developed countries, hypertensive disorder, sepsis, thrombotic microangiopathy, heart failure, acute fatty liver, postpartum hemorrhage. Diagnosis of AKI, history and clinical examination, increase in serum creatinine of 0.3 mg per deciliter, renal ultrasound that are obtained to rule out post renal causes of AKI may show hydronephrosis, serological tests, and may be kidney biopsy. Prevention of AKI in pregnant women, close observation for early signs of sepsis syndrome, and shock in women with pyelonephritis, septic abortion, and chorioamnionitis. Prompt and vigorous replacement of blood in instance of massive hemorrhage, such as in placental abortion, abruption, placenta previa, uterine rupture, and postpartum uterine atony. Control of blood pressure and determination of pregnancy complicated by severe preeclampsia or eclampsia, and careful blood replacement if loss is excessive. Avoidance of potent diuretics to treat oliguria before initiating appropriate effort to ensure that cardiac output is adequate for renal perfusion. How about pregnancy in CKD? Defining the CKD and pregnancy due to the physiological shift in the typical markers of CKD, serum creatinine and urine protein. Defining the CKD in pregnancy is difficult. Commonly used the formula to estimate creatinine clearance or estimate GFR are inaccurate in pregnancy. 24-hour urine collection for inulin clearance remains the gold standard of for GFR measurement, but are clinically impractical and rarely needed. Preserved mildly reduced renal function, creatinine less than 1.4, good outcome for pregnancy and renal disease, challenging but possible. Moderately impaired renal function, creatinine 1.4 to 2.8, risk of progression of renal failure increases fetal risk. Severe renal insufficiency, creatinine more than 2.58, high fetal and maternal morbidity and mortality. High grade proteinuria and severe hypertension also important risk factors for progression of renal disease and pregnancy worse outcome. A recent systemic review and meta-analysis was able to identify 1,342 patients in 23 studies to assess the risk of adverse pregnancy outcome, noting an approximately 10-fold increased risk of preeclampsia, a 5-fold increased risk of preterm delivery, and small for gestation age babies. Traditionally, it was considered that CKD progressively worsened in pregnant women, especially with serious vascular changes or renal insufficiency before pregnancy. Therefore, women with CKD were usually advised to avoid gestation except for recipient of renal transplant with stable renal function. Primary renal diagnosis and outcome. CKD etiology has less influence on outcome than CKD stage, proteinuria, hypertension, and preeclampsia. An exception in systemic lupus nephritis, outcome are poorer than for women with comparable renal impairment from other causes, particularly if associated with antiphospholipid antibody. CKD etiology. Women with autosomal dominant polycystic kidney disease have an increased risk of preeclampsia and urinary tract infection. Hepatic cysts may enlarge in the estrogenic environment, and known cerebral aneurysms should be assessed prior to labor. There is also a risk of intracystic hemorrhage during labor, and large renal cysts should be monitored prior to and following delivery. All women with advanced CKD require careful follow-up by nephrologist, high risk of obstetrician, as well as availability of specialized neonatal intensive care unit care. This antenatal care include blood pressure management. Target is below 140 over 90. Blood pressure should be monitored and looked using home device. Acceptable agent in the, including long-acting nifedipine, labetalol, and methyl-dopa. Management of proteinuria and nephrotic syndrome. Safe immunosuppressive option, including prednisolone, calcineurin inhibitor, and other cyclophosphamide. Rasmolecade is absolute contraindicated. Emotional support also is needed for antenatal care. Medication for preeclampsia to prevention, like folic acid, fetal surveillance, biophysiological profile, fetal growth assessment, and all of fetal surveillance are indicated. How about pregnancy in patients with lupus nephritis? Lupus nephritis, there has a maternal complication or fetal complication. Maternal complication include preeclampsia, preterm delivery, fetal complication, spontaneous abortion, stillbirth, fetal loss, continuous neonatal lupus, congenital heart block. Lupus flare, maybe lupus nephritis during pregnancy may lead to lupus flare and renal disease progression. This picture of cutaneous babies of lupus woman. Risk factor for pregnancy loss in lupus patient: active disease within 6 months prior to conception, active disease during pregnancy, systemic lupus onset during pregnancy, secondary antiphospholipid and triglyceride syndrome positive, hypocomplementinemia, double strand positive, thrombocytopenia, chronic hypertension, pre-existing renal disease, and first trimester proteinuria. So safe pregnancy lupus must be a normal kidney function, no antiphospholipid antibody, no activity, normal blood pressure. Management preconception, appropriate timing of planning pregnancy, risk of intubation following baseline investigation like CBC, urea creatinine, liver function, ANA, anti-DNA. Relative contraindication to pregnancy in lupus nephritis patient, severe lupus flare within the past 6 months, stroke within the past 6 months, pulmonary hypertension, moderate to severe heart failure, severe valvopathy, severe restrictive lung disease, chronic kidney disease stage 4-5, uncontrolled hypertension, previous severe early onset, preeclampsia before 28 week. Management after conception, hydroxychloroquine is given to prevent flare, low dose aspirin is administered, antiphospholipid positive, heparin or low molecular weight heparin and low dose aspirin. Use of immunosuppressive agents in pregnancy. Many immunosuppressive drug pregnant CKD patient usually considered relatively safe with when absolutely needed. As a cyclobrin, cyclosporin A, tacrolimus, steroid, and hydroxychloroquine. But to be avoid cyclophosphamide, MMF, rituximab, and MO2 inhibitor. Pregnancy in hemodialysis patients. End-stage renal disease require dialysis is associated with a marked decrease in fertility. Pregnancy, however, occurs in approximately 1% of patients usually within the first few years of starting dialysis. Pregnancy rate on peritoneal dialysis are even lower, occurring at approximately one half the rate of that reported for an hemodialysis. The fetal outcome is quite poor. Only 23 to 55% of pregnancy result in surviving infants. A large number of second trimester spontaneous abortion occur. Surviving infants have significant morbidities. Approximately 85% of surviving infants are born premature. Maternal complications occur as well. Several maternal diseases have been reported. Hypertension worsens in more than 80% of pregnant female on dialysis and is a major concern. But there's good news for the pregnant for pregnancy and hemodialysis patient. During the past 37 years, the survival of infant born to women on chronic hemodialysis has improved from 20% to as high 85%. There's improvement in care, improvement in dialysis, improvement in many things. That lead to good pregnancy could be continued and good babies could be developed. So improving fertility in hemodialysis patients need a new hemodialysis regimen, special dialysate formula, either therapy, new hemodialysis modalities. Some papers noted that successful twin pregnancy in patient with long-term hemodialysis, also successful triple pregnancy in a patient on chronic hemodialysis, hemodialysis prescription in pregnant patient, intensification of dialysis, adequate supply of calories and protein, antihypertensive regimen, correction of anemia, avoidance of metabolic acidosis, reinforced fetal monitoring as soon as viability is reached. How about intensification of dialysis? A blood urea nitrogen should be monitored below 50 milligrams per deciliter to avoid polyhydramnios. If hemodialysis is used, intensification of the regimen should be considered. 5 to 7 sessions per week is likely to provide more optimal control of uremia. Adequate supply of calorie, protein intake should be 1 gram per kg per day, plus an additional 20 gram per day for fetal growth. That should be supplemented with water soluble vitamins and zinc. Antihypertensive regimen, we all know the antihypertensive correction of anemia, target hemoglobin 10 to 11, avoidance of metabolic acidosis, prevention of hypocalcemia by oral calcium and extra. How about pregnancy in renal transplant recipient? Pregnancy is advisable if there has been no rejection within the past year, adequate and stable graft function, creatinine less than 1.5 milligram per deciliter, or no or minimal proteinuria, no acute infections that may impact fetal growth, maintenance immunosuppression is stable, no teratogenic medication, normal graft ultrasound, no or controlled hypertension. Special circumstances that impact on recommendations, rejection within the first year, maternal age, comorbid factors, established medical non-compliance. Complication in pregnancy, the normal national transplant registry reports that the maternal complications that occur more commonly than the general population include hypertension, preeclampsia, and diabetes. Up to 10% of patients on calcineurin inhibitor may require insulin during pregnancy. Fetal and bottleneck complications include growth restriction, preterm labor, and an increased rate of cesarean delivery. Better vaginal or cesarean, I will escape. Risk factor for poor graft outcome, baseline renal function, hypertension, and good baseline graft function, maternal hypertension is absent. Rejection in pregnancy, nationally recommended transplant kidney biopsy in case of graft function dysfunction to elicit the cause. Ultrasound guide renal allograft biopsy is relatively well tolerated and indicated when there is a clinical suspicion of rejection. Failure to do biopsy may lead to misdiagnosis and delay in appropriate treatment. Recommended immunosuppression, prednisolone less than 15 milligram per day, azathioprine less than 2 milligram kg per day, cyclosporine or tacrolimus at therapeutic level. But MMF, sirolimus are contraindicated. MMF and sirolimus should be stopped 6 weeks before conception attempted. And thank you.